Our next distinguished speaker is Mr. Pavan Kumar Vijay, a very seasoned professional, our former president. He doesn't need any introduction. Straightforward, I'm going to invite him. Pavan sir, he would be deliberating upon opportunity under insolvency and bankruptcy code. Pavan sir.
Good morning, friends. Good morning. अभी तो लंच का टाइम हुआ नहीं भाई, मेरे एक स्पीकर और बाकी है. फ्रेंड्स सिटिंग ऑन द डाइस एंड ऑफ द डाइस, आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू NIRC टू इनवाइटिंग मी फॉर दिस सेशन एंड टॉकिंग ऑफ माय फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट ऑन अपॉर्चुनिटी, बिकॉज आई ऑलवेज सी अपॉर्चुनिटी एवरीवेयर. डी मोनेटाइजेशन आई एम सीइंग lot of opportunities. And I was just thinking that how this insolvency law will change the face of our profession. It is visible and it is writing on the wall. But this writing on the wall, who can read? Only those who can read, those who are thinking that I can do it. So anybody who is thinking that I can do it, he can visualize and he can reach to that level also. Friends, what I am doing, I'll cover the some case studies also. I'll try to help because we do restructuring, and I recall I was a company secretary in Gwalior Steps in 91 and 92. There was a one director of mine, Dr. W.R. Korea. He was a director in Bhopal, the Anderson also, that company which is Bhopal Tragedy Company. So he was director and he asked me, Pavan, what is your career? I told company secretary. Pulu, no, no, this is not a career. This is your education qualification. What is your career? So I told, I want to become the successful company secretary. He told that everybody wants. Then I thought, sir, I want to earn money. Well, everybody wants. But what is your career? Then I was confused, what is the meaning of career here? I'm a company secretary, that's my career. So he rejected these points. So he told me, what you like the most? And the thing which you like the most, you are doing, that is your career. And then he asked me, what is your liking? So I was thinking, then I thought, and I told him, sir, I like change, how to change certain things. So he told me, you go for restructuring. And believe me, friend, he pointed out the right point. I love restructuring. I love how to restructure. And the most important thing is, I love to convert the deadly patient into a better and healthy patient. That's a basic thing which he inculcated this point in me. Now, these all things must be having in your minds also. So if we are discussing today something related to insolvency, then friends, for at least for this session, you just forget that you are a procedural, compliance-oriented professional. Just think that you are a professional who has to do something different. Then you will enjoy this session. Now, first, you have to understand that why this insolvency law is required in India. We have a sick company law, we have a winding up process, but now this is the required insolvency and bankruptcy code of 2016. Is it ease of doing business? It is reviving economy? It is protecting lenders or business? Or this is just protecting sickness? So friends, this is a combination of so many things. It is not addressing only on one part. The problem in India is that whenever we are making a law, we are thinking that this is targeting these people. And Mr. Sahu has rightly pointed out, it is not an opportunity. It is a duty. Because all rights come with responsibility, and all opportunity come with obligation. So you have some different obligation. Obligation towards country, obligation towards business, obligation towards to do something which is assigned. Now, why this law is required? We have a 139 position in the world for ease of doing business. If we are going for restructuring or the insolvency process, we are taking 4.3 years, this is an average, to restructure, to bind up. In India, there are so many companies are not coming and starting their own company because they think if we are incorporating a company and starting a business, we cannot close it because it's taking too much time. What lenders are getting? Here only 25%. If you compare Finland, Japan, they are getting 90%, 88%. Here we are getting only 25%. Time, I told you, 4.3 is the average. But as compared to Japan, 6 months, Finland, 9 months. So you can compare that how much and the gap is there. Cost. What is the cost of doing all these restructuring? India is the highest, 12.3% is the cost of entire business to revive the industry. It is unacceptable and it is not at all viable. As compared to other country, Korea, it has 2.3% of the entire structuring. So you can understand the highest and lowest and you can realize what is my cost structure. Now, why this sickness is taking place? Why I'm talking about these things? Because you will understand that this session is a business session. It is not the law and compliance. So there is a one saying, Christianity, this capitalism without bankruptcy is Christianity without hell. Like हमारे इधोज में हमारे इस बेदाज में भी लिखा है जो आएगा वो जाएगा जो आज यहाँ है वो ऊपर पहुँचेगा जो ऊपर है वो नीचे आएगा. So all these things is a part. कि if there is a business, there is a sickness. There is a business, there is a loss also because it's a risk. It's not every time your risk is complete. Now why these industries are going for sickness? Is it a reason that somebody has taken over the money, somebody is manipulating? Answer is no. I'll just give you an example. There are some business dynamics. Now you are seeing that today you have a business, but e-commerce is coming in a new way. So they are restructuring and they're rephrasing the entire business. Then technological changes. Now technological changes are taking too fast. One person came to me last year and he was asking me that we have a very innovative business model. And what was the business model? They were saying like this Ola and Uber, same thing, we are starting a motorcycle business also. Like we can give riding to the person who can, and our riders will take them to different places. And that is very popular in China. China mein bahut traffic jam hota hai. To wo motorcycle wale ghoomte hain. Wo kehte hain meri, ab, wo, they are having a two person. One rider, one pilot and the driver. So the driver will take you there. And the other person will take your car key and then he will bring your car to the destination. So that is their business. So he was saying that we want to start here, but we want to start only the motorcycle thing. So I asked him only one question, that Ola and Uber, they are having entire business thing. Now suppose the business which you are saying it will be a flourishing, tomorrow if Ola and Uber start the same business, what will you do? They will take only 2 minutes to add that service and your entire business will collapse. And that is happening. And that has happened with the same person. Now somebody came to me, and this is very interesting, which you should know. He told me ki Delhi mein bahut sare hotel na unko jo Delhi ke resident unko uske alawa kisi ka us Delhi ke resident ko hotel nahi dete ya newly unmarried people ko nahi dete. So they have started, there's a called stayuncle.com. This is a site. So they are providing, identifying the hotels which are providing for unmarried people these rooms. And they are charging double the rate for 12 hours stay, 8 hours stay, another thing. So I told this is business is good. It's a looking, everybody will die. But suppose I am taking something for half a day and you are charging 50, more than 100%. So that person will take the hotel for the whole day. The point is, these types of business model which are coming in India, they are not realizing that what will be the future if some new thing will come. So this is another reason of development and technological changes which are taking place. Recently, if you have read an article, today the time is apps. Everybody is saying we are downloading these apps and these apps. But now there is a prediction that these apps will be outdated. And artificial intelligence will take over the apps. You feed, like you have seen the ad of Google. You are feeding waste the time and you must be seeing that one person is reading newspaper and one person is reading from his telephone and then mobile phone, then he's saying the all the news which that person is reading. So these are the new things which are coming. You just tell the Google, it will search and give it to you. So now the question is, what is the purpose of multiple apps? So this is another risk which will take in future. Competition. Now competition within and outside of India. That is also challenging and giving a sickness. China is one of the main culprit for India, which is happening. Bad management. I am a good person, but my policies or decision making is bad. But sometime I'm a reckless businessman. So my business is bad because of this reason. Last point is the manipulator. There are some people, those who manipulate, transferring business from that, and they are also creating sickness. So do you think in India, this is a large number? No, answer is no. Yes, these type of people are there, but this is not in the large number. Large number is, what are the other things, other factors I have told? These are the things which are creating sickness. Now, how this sickness is creating in India? Sickness is creating because there are so much procedural. After studying so many years, I am so confused sometime whether this matter is going to BFR or DRT or how the, if you are a lender or you are a borrower, how to handle it. You file the case in DRT, he will go to the High Court. You file this case, they will go to this court. So many combinations, so many multiple agency that is hindering and creating lot of procedure. There is an attitude of the bankers. Bankers are always thinking that my interest should be there. I attended one meeting of the lenders, consortium banker. The management was saying, I require this much of money and the money is not, it's only 2 or 3% what you have given, but I can revive. They were listening and then saying, when are you paying the interest? He's saying, I'm not having money to pay my labor. How can I pay my interest? And their entire tape recorder was going on and asking only one thing, when are you paying my interest? So for what you are here? Bankers are sending their clerks, junior officers. They are only one dimension that you have to get back the money. That's all. Or just talk to about the interest. I have seen, I'm on the board of one institution. I asked them how you are giving loan. The bankers of India is seeing only one thing, that is ratios. You sit on the laptop, make CMA data, submit it, and get the loan. If your CMA data is not good, you'll not get. I talked to one banker for our companies, because sometime you require liquidity. I said, give me 1 crore rupees OD, so sometime though we don't require money, but sometimes some problem can be there, debtors are not paying. So he's saying your ratios are not matching. I told, I have a fund, I have a strong position, but they are saying it's not matching. So they work on ratios. Their attitude is totally different. They just working on the old type of thing that is creating sickness. Now friends, the most important thing of the law. Why this BFR versus today's insolvency law? Now, old BFR, it was just a tool for shelter to avoid problems. That you file BFR case, so you are protected and you will get exemption. That was the basic aim. But now, the new law of this insolvency is protecting or talking about the cash flow. It is not talking about the erosion of net worth. Now, previously, we were focusing on net worth erosion. Today, we are focusing on cash flow. I'll give you an example that how the Indian law BFR or the sickness was so bad and so wrong that why not we have protected or we have protested this point. Now how the problem starts? There is a first problem is liquidity problem. Sometime you are doing business, there's a liquidity problem for any reason. Your some factory got fire, some labor strike, some any other reason, so your liquidity is affected. When your liquidity is affecting, then what is happening? Your project or your payments will delayed. And when the payments are delayed, then your operations are affected. When operations are affected, then there is a possibility you are not able to pay money to the vendors, not pay money to the raw material supplier, and your operations affected. When operation affected, then your operational losses starts. And then after the operational losses will continue, then you will find that your erosion of net worth will start. Now, erosion of net worth will start after this seventh or eighth point. In India, we were thinking that is the time when we identified and we say this company is a sick company. It is a totally unrealistic issues, and I don't know how the various government has not seen this. Take example of Kingfisher. Take example of Dimak. Aapke ghar mein Dimak lag jaye. तो ये वही सिस्टम है कि दीमक लगने के बाद जब वो उसको आप हिलाते हो ना वो पूरा बिल्डिंग ही नीचे आ जाए, इस तरह का सिस्टम होता है. और वी आर अवेयर नाउ दीमक हैज स्टार्टेड ईटिंग माय एसेट. किंगफिशर फ्लरिशिंग बिजनेस, एवरीथिंग वाज गुड, बट दे वर नॉट एबल टू पे मनी, देयर ऑपरेशन लॉसेज वर देयर देयर एंड एवरीबडी वाज सीइंग किंगफिशर मीन द यूनाइटेड ब्रेवरीज, बट इट इज नॉट. Because you should realize that Kingfisher is separate, United Breweries are separate. You were paying money to them, they were in loss, but you were funding them. And after some time, suddenly you have stopped funding. So the funding, when it has stopped, the company has collapsed because of various reasons. Kingfisher is the same example which I have told how the operation losses has started. The erosion of net worth has taken place after so many years. But these problems were earlier visible to everybody. Now, this type of problems in India, the new law, bankruptcy, I think it is a correct step, because they are saying if you are not paying and within 1 month you can file and the company and the lenders can file case. So you are arresting the problems at the right time, not you are raising after some time. Only challenge is which I am thinking that is a time bound problem. They are saying within 90 days, within 180 days, you have to do various things. Now, Mr. Sahu has mentioned, because me and Mr. Sahu, we are very old people and worked in the capital market. He gave you an example of T+1, how the settlement system has changed. But I am giving one example. When we were in the broking company and NSC came, bed delivery system was there. So the bed delivery correction was taking place, because you all are company secretary knowing how the bed delivery was taking place. It is taking 45 days, 30 days, 45 days, 90 days. NSC came and they told no, within 7 days you have to ratify the bed deliveries. There was a too much hue and cry in the market that how it can be solved. But believe me, NSC was strict to the point, and within 7 days, all the brokers and all the company has started ratifying, and within 7 days it was going on, and they have changed it. So if you want to do it, things will take. So don't see that we can't do it. 180 days is very less period. This is not a less period. It is sufficient period. You have to work on your toes. Now how the time will change, that I'll give you an example. And example which is the layman style. If you have to go to airport, what you are doing? You are calculating your time of commuting, then 1 hour before you are reaching, and every time you are reaching, if you are, otherwise you will miss. Railway station, if you are doing, then you are just doing commuting time and reaching to the platform, you are calculating. If you are going to bus stand, because it's not much travel, But if you are going by taxi, because taxi meter starts, so you will try to do this. But you are going by own car, you will try, and you can delay the process. But there is a one very ticklish or typical scenario which we all have experienced. There is a one person or one group, when they do and when they go, they always delay the entire process. That is called the Baratis. So the Baratis are always, agar unko bolo 10 baje jana hai, to 11, 12, 1, 2, because there's no system for this. Aur hamare India mein hota bhi ye system hai. To jitne ye companies mein log jo paise le lete hain, unka ek attitude barat wala bhi hota hai, ke paise le liye, ab main apne hisab se, I'll pay. Now these are the things which are creating problems. Ki main paise le liye, ab main is court mein dal dunga, main is court mein dal dunga, main yahan delay kar dunga. That process has to stop. So 180 days is sufficient if you want to restructure and talk like business. But the question is, friend, I was just listening and I'm seeing that 70 members has enrolled, chartered accountant has already enrolled. So, and I'm getting so many Facebook appreciation also, that somebody is saying I got this and everybody is congratulating him. So do you think that after taking this certificate, you will become insolvency professional and you will revive things? Answer is no. Don't do this mistake. But I am not discouraging, but I am just telling you, this is an opportunity to us, to all of us, to showcase our capabilities. Whatever we have done, whatever we want to do it, this is a time to showcase. So the insolvency, if you think that I am an insolvency professional and I got a certificate by paying 10,000 rupees, my work is over, no, friends. You have to do so many things. You have to change your attitude, that I will cover at the last. Now, issue is how you can do it. This I am saying with my experience and how you can restructure. And this I am doing. When the insolvency law came, we got one case, and the first case which we are doing, and this is for the benefit of all of you, that if you want to do it, it's not something rocket science. It is only thing is, you have to focus on this. So first is that you have to have a knowledge. Knowledge of law, knowledge of finance, knowledge of valuation, and various other knowledge which you require to do certain things. Then you have a skill of understanding and the business acumen. So three skills you require. You require leadership, you require decision making, and you require the most important, that is a business acumen. It is not the law and compliance. It's a business. Sometimes we say, ye nahi ho sakta. Management kehta, mujhe karna hai. Aap kehte ho ki mera, sir, aapki date lag gayi. Agle mahine ki ya 3 mahine baad ki. You are not understanding his 500 crore rupees merger is delayed because of this 3 months date. So he is worried about. So if you understand that this is the business, that way you have to do, so you will realize his problem. So business acumen and business things you require, and that is very essential. Now, I'm just covering, suppose some case has come to you, and you have to, as an insolvency professional, you have to solve this. The question is it a tough job? Yes, it is not easy, but it is not impossible. So you have to just work out. So first, understand the business of that company. You have to understand what this business is, how the industry is doing, what are the issues and what are the dynamics of that company also. Sometimes the same industry, but dynamics are different. Then you have to understand the reason of insolvency, the reason of this sickness, why this company is sick, what are the reason, whether it's a technological issue, whether it's a business issue, whether it's a competitor issue, whether it's bad decision making, that you have to understand. Then you have to work out the viability analysis, whether this company can be revived if following 3-4 things can take place, and then you can think on this. Then you have to meet and understand the lenders' problem, because lenders have their own issues, so you have to meet them. Then you have to meet the promoter, understand their issues, and the KMPN take their views that how you can revive. Sometime management and the junior management can give you some new innovative ideas that you do is. Then you do the most important thing, which I am always talking to my clients. You just work out the distressed valuation of the company. Distressed valuation means that if you have to sell this company, then what will be the money you will get? Now, this valuation will help you to talk to the lenders. Sometimes lenders saying, I have a 100 crore rupees loan. And you are saying the company has only 25 crore rupees asset value. So what will you will get? So you will not get 100 crore rupees. You have to come to that level. So distressed valuation and a very simple formula I am suggesting to all of you. What you do is you make a four column analysis. There is a liability size, there is an asset side. You write down the all liabilities and take the basic fact. All liabilities are one side. What is the liability of the company in the books and what is the liability can be settled by the, suppose the liability is 100 crore and the bank is ready for 70 crore. So you have to write that 70 crore, I can settle it. Then you go to the asset side. Whatever assets which has a value in the books, but what is the real value? Compare this, you can find out what is my distressed asset sale. This you have to do, and this is not very tough job. You can easily do. And after this, you have to see the viability, how the company can revive, how much fund you require, that you have to do. Then you have to see whether this existing management can revive this company, or you have to search some, or with the help of a strategic investor or some new partner, you can do and you can work out that how it can take place. Then you have to understand that in the entire business, which portion is unviable, you can sell it. Which business, how you can reduce the cost, how you can bring out certain new things which can revive the business and which can take away the unimportant part which is taking place. Sometime you have to do financial restructuring. One company came to us long back. It has a 600 crore rupees net worth, 3,000 crore rupees loan, and they have a 2,800 crore rupees losses. Now this company you have to restructure. Now you can understand the capital is totally wiped out. It's a sick company. So what we did, we assigned the entire loan of 3,000 crore to some other person. Because if he is buying the loan and then you are settling, then there is a tax aspect. So the 3,000 crore rupees loan, he has assigned to some third party who is the investor. And that person convert this 3,000 crore rupees as a equity. So now the company's equity is 600 plus 3,000, 3,600, and the loss is 2,800 crore. Now you reduce the capital. So 3,600 minus 2,800 crore, 800 crore rupees capital is there. No loss and no loan now. So you can understand this is one area where you have to work out how the restructuring, financial restructuring you can do. And after that, you have to bring out a revival plan with the help of creditors and with the help of management. And all these revival plan, you have to work out and you have to suggest to the lenders they should accept. And then after this, if you think that after all revival it is not possible, then it is better to close this business that you suggest. So friends, I have just narrated any sick industry you take out, but for this you require various knowledge. Knowledge of valuation, knowledge of finance, knowledge of law, knowledge of other thing. Here, compliance in procedure is a very negligible portion. There is not only 10 or 20%. Now, basic point. Why I'm emphasizing on this? Because I'm also part of this and I'm giving a lecture to all of you and discussing with the professional. Sometime we think that I'm asking somebody what you are doing. They are saying we are doing merger also. So what is the meaning of merger in our dictionary? RD approval and OL approval. That is merger for us. And for that, somebody is outsourcing that work because that donkey's work he can't do, so he's giving to us. That is not merger, boss. Merger is planning, restructuring. If that company, they are doing restructuring and they are charging 50 lakh rupees, they are giving you 2 lakh rupees. So just understand how much percentage you are getting, and you are thinking that that is the entire work. Other merger work, which are a simple merger, that is there also, but that is a legal merger. So don't feel happy that you are doing merger by doing this. Go to NCLT. You find NCLT, all tough related issues, advocates are going. For all these procedural issues, we are going. Why it is happening? Why you have a fear to go there? Now the NCLT has provided you, or the New Companies Act has provided, that you can do entire merger work. Previously, people were saying, sir, hum court nahi ja sakte, isliye we can't do this. But today, you can go to the court. So try to do the entire work. So why I'm saying this? Now time has come. Friends, pehle din, jahan bhi jaoge, wahan joote hi khaoge. Maan ke chalo, pitai hogi pehle din. Go there and do it. When I was speaking first time in 1995, because we are from Hindi background, so our English is, you can understand, jaisi hai waisi hai, bol lete bas. So we are not able to, kyunki hum logo ko do struggle karne padte hain. Ek to struggle karo ki pehle samjho, phir uski translation karo, to isi mein bahut time beet jata hai. So now this is a problem with everybody. We have a fear. Remove this fear. Ek baar daant padegi, do baar daant padegi, ek baar pitoge, do baar pitoge, fear nikalo. Ye fear nikal ke NCLT mein ghus jao. Company secretary should control NCLT work. Now you have so many opportunities in NCLT. Insolvency is another part. So just try and enter it. My request to all of you, that this is an area where you can work out and you can do wonders. Only thing is that you open your mind and remove the hackles of just thinking that I am a compliance guy. Friends, this insolvency work will not run by compliance people. Understand. You can do this, you can add value, but you cannot complete this. So you have to work out that you have to create business things, you have to create something where you can revive. This is a golden opportunity to reinvent yourself, to rethink yourself, and repositioning yourself by understanding various new things and new law. And the most important thing, that you must understand business. Understand business, you know the law, you know so many things, you know the finance. Only thing, you have to just rope in everything together and present yourself as an insolvency professional. I told you, it is not impossible, no doubt. It requires more efforts. It is tough, but it is not impossible. So try to do this. And there are so many people. Read various restructuring scheme, how the people have done. You read various new aspects, and then try to do this, that this is the area where company secretary can become real insolvency professional, and read the international law, international people, international success story, and various other things. Read, read, and read. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pawan sir, for beautifully dealing with the various opportunities available in the IBC, and also for dealing with the nitties and gritties of the opportunities. You rightly said, we are the professional who have to do something different, and also this is the time to showcase our capabilities. मैं समझता हूँ कि आज के बाद सबका fear जो है धीरे धीरे दूर होना शुरू हो जाएगा और सब लोग जो NCLT और IBC में जो opportunities available है उसका लाभ उठाएंगे.